Jusuf Wanandi.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Good fight. Well, I would like to expand a little bit because the three speakers has been concentrating on North Korea, and it's rightly so because this is the most maybe acute problem at this juncture. But at the same time, I consider that only as a symptom of the uncertainties of the region. And I do think, as in other regions we have talked about in the last 2 days, uncertainty is the new normal in East Asia as well. And now, why? Let me try to explain some of the background. I think basically and mainly it is because of the rise of China, and especially now with President Xi Jinping's strong leadership. And then on the other hand is the election of President Trump, who has brought many uncertainties for us, as you know, because there is no doubt, as far as I am concerned, in the last maybe 1 year or so, just also even before the elections, you know, we cannot follow what he really have in mind. That is maybe the most critical issue for me. If there is more certainties, then we know how to react. But with President Trump, we just don't know. And not only we don't know, he is also changing every day. What do you want to do with this man, you see, as a leader? So therefore, there are basic problems arising now, how we have to react, how we have to do next with the lacunas, with the gaps that has been established because of these uncertainties. Now, I do think that we should be positive and active. We cannot just leave it and walk away from it. And that's why I do think that meetings like this is a critical, important events that could at least create understanding and better understanding, if not, you know, of the issues and of the policies coming up in this relationship that I'm talking about. And secondly, also taking actions, taking cooperation, and as a filling of the possible gaps that has already been and has already started to be created. What do I mean by that? We definitely have to recognize the United States is an important country. And therefore, we cannot just leave her behind because she is too important to be left behind, basic. But of course, you know, we have to do all the efforts that is necessary to be done. But mind you, I have my doubts definitely, and it will be very great efforts on us, and even then, I still have my doubts. I don't know whether anything will be followed because he has a bunch of aides around him, especially the generals, who are trying to do just that on the security of East Asia particularly, to show, you know, to him that the existing, actually, institutions and relationship that the United States has in the region is still very important and can just not be denied. And because Trump losing leave, of course, you know, besides the problem of jetting up the atmosphere on the North Korean problem and nuclear problem, which is not paying off, it makes everybody just a little bit more confused and excited. But furthermore, what has he brought in the news as new policies? But so that is definitely, you know, this is where we have to cooperate also, because we have to stand up against this type of actually policies in the future and the uncertainties thereof. Now, secondly, I would like to argue is after we have to try it, and definitely we have to try it out again and again, and now President Trump is in the region, and he is going to two ASEAN countries, one in Vietnam, for APEC, and the other one is for ASEAN East Asian Summit in Manila. Now, hopefully, this is one of these efforts I said, where we have to persuade him and deal with him and try to convince him that all these policies that we have had are good. Now, but otherwise, you know, besides all these efforts, we also have to look possibilities of how to cooperate among ourselves. And if China showed, and that is the paradox, of course, you know. Here we have actually a liberal leader, supposedly to be leading the world and the governance system of the world, and compared to a more authoritarian rule and more, you know, actually illiberal man, now open up to the problems that we are facing. It is Xi Jinping who said, I'm going to take the lead in opening up the trade arrangements, etc. I'm going to take the lead in the climate change problem. I'm going to take the lead also, you know, in changing and leadership of the world as such. So therefore, we also have to try out with China what she meant and what she is willing to do. We can just not leave that as an open question, because I think cooperation is a very necessary thing. And therefore, even with China, we have to deal with China in the right way. Open up, knows exactly what she is willing to do, and she has, of course, to show the seriousness of cooperation as she has done and try to do in the South China Sea that has been mentioned by Michael. We have now concluded the framework for this COC, so-called the Code of Conduct, and we hope that next year or so we can implement that in more concrete legal forms. So secondly, of course, we are also now trying to do this regional trading arrangement, the RCEP, so-called, the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership in East Asia. And we try at least here also to do our part how to deal with this issue, which is so critical for the region, because the region is so dependent on economic cooperation. Maybe let me stop at that, because the moderator become serious, I think, a little bit nervous now for the time. So let me stop at that and open up, of course, for questions later on. Thank you.
Thank you very much.